everybody. What's going on? Welcome to the latest edition of the Westwood Living Podcast. I am in the office of one Mike DiSarro, who you know as the owner of Neroli Mercato and Ristorante. And for many of you, you might know Mike as, once upon a time, a Westwood High School student. I mean, you have deep roots in Westwood. How have things been going with you?
That's right. Everything's been fantastic.
Lot to talk about. Most notably, the fact that your one-year anniversary is coming up. So a lot has happened. I recall being here in February of 22. When we were kind of both launching this new venture in Westwood, your venture and my venture.
I had met you when literally the place was dust. That's all that existed in the Mercato at the time.
But think about how much has changed, and I'm obviously curious about how much you've learned and what has been, you know, the best part and maybe even the worst part about what you've experienced here in the year since it officially opened, the Mercato.
Yes. So, I mean, most people know I've been in hospitality for about 12 years now prior to opening up my own restaurant, right? And you never really know what's going to come of your first venture. And we started with the Mercato. So next week on September 16th is going to be our 1 year anniversary of getting that open. And you never know what to expect, right? I grew up here. There was not much here when I was a kid. You had CVS, Cafe Diva, a barber shop, and Islington Pizza. That's all you had down here. And things have changed a lot. And coming down here, it's so much different. It's so much more vibrant. There's lights down here. The only light that existed when I was a kid was literally the street lights. There was nothing down here. So I think it looks beautiful. I think the town and the surrounding area has been so receptive of me opening this. I think it was needed to have something like this down here. I mean, it's been a major undertaking, but the reception I've gotten from this town and from everyone, especially on this side of Islington, where I grew up just a block away, has been the dream completed to me in my eyes.
So it was two-tiered because you did launch the Mercato before ultimately you opened the restaurant on March 2nd. I won't forget that date, the day we had our winter social. That was opening night here. But to do it in the manner that you did it, we're kind of, I don't even know if it's half the business. I don't know how it's broken down, but let's just call it half the venture is the Mercato. Would you do it the same way again? Was that the right way to get the brand out there, to get it started, get the ball rolling in the right direction?
I wouldn't know the answer to that just yet, but I think that the way we did it was successful. So we came out of the gate with the market and set the expectation for everyone. I think everyone's seen what we build, how we build our sandwiches in there, the product that we're putting out. It's a little more expensive than people are used to, which I know, but you can tell it in the product. You can tell it in the bread and the meats that we use. They're imported from Italy. It's a little different, right? But we really set the tone in there. And most of the people from the community saw that I was behind the line for the first 6 months over there prior to opening the restaurant. Like, I was right there making the sandwiches with my staff, learning the ins and outs of the business, learning customers' wants and needs as we did that. And during that time, I did realize I needed to stop working on the line because we had the restaurant coming. Mm-hmm. So managing my time during that process was difficult, obviously, especially my wife Chantal would tell you, but it was exciting. You get to make sandwiches during the day, and then we started our restaurant meetings at night, and you don't know what's going to come of it. You don't know whether the design concepts are going to come through as actual visualizations of what it actually is. So, I mean, that was exciting, right? Building anything can be exciting. It obviously has headaches, but I think from concept and renderings to what we built today, I couldn't be more proud of how this has come out. And I hope everyone appreciates it.
Well, you also did a lot on the fly. Think about the fact that when you first opened up, there was no wine or beer over there. That was always coming soon. And then it finally arrived, which is great. There wasn't as much seating over at the Mercato as there is now. And that's something that you worked through. I don't know whether that was based on feedback or just like, hey, it's coming.
The beer and wine was actually attached to getting liquor license approved with the restaurant as well. So yes, it was always coming soon. And that was a difficult process, but the town was amazing and receptive to it. They helped me along the way. And the seating was very much a feedback from people. We started really, you know, and a lot of people might not know this, or they do if they've been there a lot, but we started as wanting to really push to be an Italian market. That's the Mercato, right? But at the end of the day, I did realize that people want to enjoy these sandwiches and the product that we have over there and sit down with their family, especially on the weekends. You come in now on Saturdays and Sundays, and we specifically stay open on Sundays because when I was a kid around here, you couldn't get anything. But now to see the families being able to sit down with their kids and get a quick sandwich, and the kids menu that we rolled out, which wasn't there in the beginning either. But that all comes on feedback from the town and from all the customers that come in.
So before we get into the restaurant, an announcement per se related to the Mercato.
So we're going to end up doing a 1 year anniversary party next Saturday, and we're officially going to be starting daily breakfast. So that'll be 7 to 11 daily, coffee, lattes, espresso, chocolate croissants, different Italian items, egg sandwiches, things like that. And we'll be doing breakfast going forward, which again has been a feedback from everyone that's come to the Mercato. They want it in the morning. They want an espresso. They want to read the newspaper really quickly. And it's been a small dream of mine, right? I think I told my wife at one point, I wouldn't feel complete until I saw like an older gentleman come in, grab an espresso and the paper and sit there and sip on an espresso while reading the paper. It just reminds me of when I was in Italy, and I'm not going to stop until we get that done by next week.
Awesome. So that's the 16th of September.
Yes. We're going to do a 1 year anniversary party that day. And what we're going to do is we're going to provide everyone that comes in for Saturday and Sunday, rules will apply, but we're going to give everyone an option to get a free item, whether that's coffee, espresso, or a sandwich. All they have to do is show us that they posted on social media, and they'll be able to get one free item for each person in their family that posts. Obviously, we'll chat about that as people come in and tell them more, but we really want to give the opportunity to people to come in and try something new with us, and we'll offer them a free coffee or a free sandwich, and I think everyone's going to be really impressed. If you've had our lunch sandwiches, I'm sure you know that we have some things in store for breakfast.
So let's make the transition over to the opening and launch of Neroli Ristorante. And it was collectively quite a game plan. I know you had your own stuff going on, but we talked specifically about, you know what, let's get you on the cover of our magazine in February. So there was a lot happening there, but it did sync up really effectively.
Because we did land that perfectly.
That was good. You know, that's like killing the triple axle in the Olympics. It landed, and there you were on the cover with Chantal, and the great photography from Rick Byrne with you and your mom.
I love Mario. Rick. Rick's fantastic.
I mean, he made you look like a king. It was great. And the cover came out great. And there was the magazine sitting there. And we launched the opening of your restaurant in conjunction with the Westwood Living Winter Social, which was March 2nd. And you also had a ton of investors here and family members. And just to see that hustle and bustle, I give you guys and everybody on the staff a ton of credit for pulling that off, because that was literally your first night where you had hundreds of people in here. But yeah, that night, with your crowd, my crowd combined, we had like 250, and you pulled
Someone
it off.
Someone would call us crazy, but yeah, you know, it wasn't perfect, but I think we nailed it, right? And it was funny. I'm a younger guy, right? I'm 36 years old. I believe in digital advertising and marketing. And I think for me, after meeting you, right, I was a little skittish of magazines and print ads and radio advertising and where that stands today. And after getting the cover and with my wife and seeing the reception we got from that and people coming in and recognizing me from that cover was like outstanding to me. I remember I grabbed you. I was like, this is crazy. I feel like a small celebrity in this, my mini town, which I came back to. But, you know, it was very, you know, and I've advertised ever since. And it's a small community of great people that all see the advertisements and they actually talk to me about them. It's pretty crazy to see.
That's cool. And it was fun to do the event here, and we'll have the winter social in 2024 here. So we got to nail down a date. We'll have that discussion at a later time. But you also had the Westwood Community Chest event here shortly thereafter. That was also in March. So you came storming out of the gates. And you know, it's difficult.
Everyone was racing to be the first one in. You landed before them, but yeah, Westwood Community Chest came right after.
Well, they also took the whole restaurant.
They did.
I should say we, because now I've joined the board of the Westwood Community Chest, which is great. I'm looking forward to that. Working with Kim Chase next year and helping to arrange the next big social. But what have you learned about running a restaurant? Because yes, you've been in the entertainment industry, but this is your first foray into running a restaurant, and it's hard. This is big. This is a big spot. Big bar, lots of seats, a lot of different things that you're looking to accomplish. The supper club on Sundays. I mean, you probably got these big visions running around in your head each and every day, and you have to empower a small army of people to see your vision to the finish line. Take me through that challenge.
I think first and foremost, I think that having the ability to have it be my restaurant with investors who are they back me up and they back my vision, right? When you talk about vision, it's crazy that I finally have something where I can push my visions forward, right? I'm a city guy. I grew up in pretty much Boston at the end of the day. Like all my hospitality background started in there. So I've seen it all. I've seen bars. I've seen restaurants. I've seen nightclubs. I've seen lounges. And I think to me, bringing the vision together of having a small town feel with a city-like atmosphere is not something easy to finish and get done. But I think that people recognize it really quickly. The little details from the small Neroli sound out front makes it feel like, oh, look at this cute little restaurant. And then when people walk in, I've seen their eyes open up. Whoa. Okay, this bar is beautiful. I can sit down and have dinner. I can bring families here. They have a 100-person event space. Like, I can have a bridal shower here. They can have weddings here, you know, which eventually we will do. And I think that seeing people see that vision has been everything to me. And it's great to have it happen in my hometown.
I have seen you invest back. You know, we're looking for sponsors for the Westwood Rotary Club's pancake breakfast. Boom. Check from Mike DiSarro, without question. I know that the robotics team won, you know, their competition. And then you send me a text like, hey, who's in charge of that? We want to send them a plate full of sandwiches. So there's organic and just inherently genuine give back to the community, which I think is great. And you are doing even more of that with me as we do the Lessons from Leader series, which is coming up here in October. You're going to be one of the keynote speakers. You're doing October 18th. I hope you have that in your calendar.
Oh, I do.
And as a former Westwood High School student, I think you've got a great message that you want to convey to the current students, because it's a busy world with a lot of pressures. And when you look at where you are now, I'm sure you can't go back in time to when you were in high school 18 years ago and say, you know, I'm going to do X, Y, and Z. So what is your message that you're going to convey to the students?
I remember the day I actually told you this, and it was that, you know, to everyone to take a deep breath and that it's okay to not have it figured out. I remember it to this day because at the end of the day, I grew up in a generation where I dial up AOL internet all the way through Google, through, you know, Yahoo, all this crazy stuff, social media, Facebook. I was the original, like, you needed a .edu to get Facebook, right? So I see social media has really exploded. And I think that a lot of people, like other people that I was in high school with, you see people getting these small gradual steps forward, whether it's business, whether it's life, weddings, what are they doing in life? Are they opening a business? And I think it's a lot of competition, right? And you see your friends out there doing different things. You may not know how they got there or how they did it, but my big message to everyone in Westwood is to just take a deep breath. I didn't know when I left Westwood High School that I would eventually own a restaurant. I didn't know what I was going to do, right? I have a business major with a minor in accounting. A lot of people in college, what do you do with that? Business. What is business? That could be anything. But at the end of the day, I just find that just going with the flow of things. The first probably 10 years of graduating college, I spent doing tons of different things. I liked some, I loved some, I hated some. And you got to know that you're doing that to really find out what you're going to do and not listen to the social media and your friends talking about what they've done and what they've accomplished. And it's a constant pressure to accomplish more. And I just took my time. I feel like I'm young to own a restaurant right now, and I've got big dreams and big visions for more, but it wasn't an easy path, right? COVID changed a lot of things. That put me in a dead halt. I had no business at all. So I finally was coming out of COVID and I said, what do I really want to do with my life and how can I get it done? And I think I've accomplished that right now in a small part, and even though it feels big to everyone that comes in, but you know, I really want to get that message across to students that, like, it's okay to not have it figured out right now. Like, I don't fully have it figured out. I might look like I do, but you don't know, right? So, you know, that's the big message. I want everyone to not succumb to those pressures of seeing everyone on social media getting these different major accomplishments and where you're at. Are you getting married? Do you have kids? Do you have a business? What car do you drive? Like, none of that stuff matters. At the end of the day, it's about their happiness. So that's what I really want to talk to the students about.
You hit on a couple key things. Number one is, if I had to do it again, and I enjoy being in the quote-unquote communications, publishing, marketing, advertising business, sports business, I think I'd be a business major in college. Because I think if you major in business, to your point, you'll figure out a way to make whatever you want to do work, because you know what it takes for something to work, because you can operate a business. So that was probably a good call way back when. Secondarily, you've got a lot ahead of you. Chantal's pregnant.
That's right.
You're welcoming your first child soon.
8 weeks away. We got a Halloween baby coming, October 25th.
Oh, your life's going to change, bud.
Baby boy. I know. This is bad. No, it's good. I'm really happy.
It's going to be great. And then do you have, is it fair for me to ask, do you have a wish or vision of where you might be 5 years from now?
I think about that a lot lately now that, you know, we own this project, but I've always, and we talked on this in the article in the Westwood Living with the cover article, was I always saw my father's vision of owning hospitality ventures like restaurants, lounges, nightclubs, bars. And in 5 years, I'm hoping to have a couple more of these, right? That's the vision right now. And not just a Neroli, like I have other concept ideas in my mind for other different ventures within hospitality. So we'll see what's to come, right? I've got different ideas on my desk as we sit here, which we will keep to ourselves for now. But, you know, every day I just want to keep trying to grow and build and see what's next. If the right opportunity presents itself, then that's what it's going to be.
Well, just keep surrounding yourself with the right people. I'm glad that I'm one of those people and that we're doing business together and helping each other out as we both grow, because it's been fun to get to know you and your family and your wife and your mom and your
siblings. My family's been such an amazing support system to do this. You know, I have a lot of great uncles and aunts and my grandfather and different investors that back me and give me business advice, which I need, right? Everyone needs it. So my family's been super supportive and I love that.
9/16, next Saturday, September 16th, you're going to want to get your butts over to the Mercato, because that's when Mike and his crew are celebrating the one-year anniversary. We're all very thankful that Neroli Mercato and Ristorante has really reinvigorated the Islington area. And nothing but success to you. And thanks for joining us today.
No problem. Thank you for coming.
That is Mike DiSarro. As always, if you have somebody who you think I should catch up with and tell their story, just reach out to me. Send an email to tleyden@bestversionmedia.com, and I will connect with that person, and we will sit down, have a chat, and share their story right here on the Westwood Living Podcast Network. But for now, we say farewell, and thank you for listening.